All right, we're back. I'd like to give a shout out to Ed at Great Plains Electronics. I got my 28-pin IC twin leaf two wipe sockets in. Great Plains Electronics. And so we're going to go ahead and start with the CPU board. And I'm going to start with the 16-pin sockets. So, I'm going to go ahead and I'm just going to put one in and solder it in and let you see the process, and then I'll do the other three and then I'll move on to the other chips. Okay, I'm going to take this piece of foam and just lay it on the board and flip it over. And that'll hold the socket in. And I got another piece of foam so that it'll even up the board. All right. My solder ready. And there's this one right here. So let me see if I can get the camera zoomed in so you can see what I'm doing here. Said before, it's just the hardest is to try to get the camera in focus and lined up so that you can see what I'm doing, because otherwise there's no need for you to be here if you can't see what I'm doing. All right, well, let's give that a try. All right, first I'm going to just solder the two opposite ends. And then I always like to look and make sure that the socket is in and level. There we go. And it is. So now that we got it tacked in place, and we can go crazy and solder the rest of the pins. Okay, that's all it is to it. Now, take a look and see what it looks like in the camera here. Never can get this thing to focus all that good. Well, it looks good. That socket's in, so we got, let's see, three more to go right in this area. I'm going to go ahead and get those in, and then we'll probably go next to the 28-pin sockets right here. All right, well, we got all four of the 16-pin sockets in, so now let's start on the 28-pin sockets. So, do it the same way. I'm just gonna put the socket in. Put my piece of foam on it. Turn it over. All right. Now let's see if I can get you focused in on it here. Get you in pretty close. All right, that ought to be good enough. I moved it. Okay, let's see if we can get it tacked in. Again, check it to make sure we got the socket in flat. Looks good. And we'll just go ahead and solder in the rest of the pins. At least soldering goes a lot quicker than desoldering, but still, I never get in a big hurry. But it's an important part of the process. You need good solder joints. You don't want to put too much solder. You definitely don't want to put too little. Okay. Now it's hard to see on the camera, but look at it with the magnifying glass. And they look good. So now all we got to do is go ahead and put the other 328 pin sockets on. And then we'll move to the 240 pin sockets. Okay, I finished the 428 pin sockets here. So now let's do the 40 pin CPU socket. So we'll just drop it in. And get my piece of foam. And let's see. Do it this way. Okay, that looks like it. Well, let's see if I can get you zoomed in. That's it right there. I can get you a little closer. All right, we'll try that. Get this thing tacked in. All right, let's remove the foam and check it to make sure it's in flat, which it is. Get it repositioned a little. Now, I gotta have it so I can get the soldering iron to it. All right, let's give that a try. So far, everything's been going along real good. Hope once they get all these sockets in and get the chips in, hook the board back up, hope it works. It might, it might not. It may have other problems. We just have to figure them out as we come to them. But right now, we're taking care of the things that we know we have problems with. Corroded sockets and rotting legs on ICs. And there's only one way to fix them, and that's to remove and replace. Remove, clean, and replace. All right. See what they look like. I'm looking at these with my magnifying visor, which has a little loop on it, which magnifies it even more. So I'll show you. You can get these at, Harbor Freight. Fairly cheap. They work real good. Got this little loop on it right here that you can swing over on your right eye. Magnifies real good. Then on the inside, you also got another one that flips down that that magnifies it. So, yeah, if you're having problems seeing, you definitely need one of these unless you got one of those big desk-mounted, great big magnifiers with the built-in light. I'd probably have one of those if I had a permanent workbench, but since I don't have a permanent workbench, the head visor works just fine. Okay, well, the CPU socket is in. Now let's do the 40-pin socket for the AY sound chip. And once I do that, the CPU board will be finished. Then we can start on the video board. Okay, well, all the new sockets are on the CPU board, so now we get to move over to the video board. All right, well, here's the video board. Video board, we got 8 28-pin sockets to put in, one 24-pin socket, and one 16-pin socket. So we'll start with one of the 28 pins. So let's see, eeny, meeny, miny, moe. Let's start with this one right here. All right. Put a foam down again. Well, that should be pretty good. See if I can zoom in here. Yeah, that's it right there. Oops. Okay, let's try that. Again, I'm just going to tack the two corners. Well, actually, I'm going to solder the two corners in. Two opposite corners, which will hold it in, and I'll make sure that it's in straight, which it is. I get it back in frame. And let's go ahead and solder these up. And just like that, we're done. Take a good look at it. Looks good. There it is right there. So we'll go ahead and finish up putting these seven more on, and then I'll bring you back when we're ready to do the 24 pin socket. Okay, all the 28 pin sockets are done. So now let's do the 24 pin socket. Go ahead and stick this one in. Get in there. There it goes. Put my foam block on there to hold it in place. And let's see if I can get you lined up. That ought to be good enough. Go ahead and tack the corners down. Check to make sure it's in level. And it is. Now go ahead and solder it in. And that's all done. Take a quick look at it here. And that looks good. Okay. All we got left is the 16 pin socket, which I think a prom goes in. That in. Put a foam to hold it up. adjust it right here. Okay. Go ahead and tack it in. Check it, make sure it's level. Looks good. Let's go ahead and solder it in. Get this one in and we will be done with the sockets. Get a close look at this. Yeah, these two pins are bridged together. They're supposed to be. They're tied together. When you're soldering, you want to make a note of that before you solder it, because once you solder it, sometimes you can't tell if it was supposed to be that way or if you made a mistake and did a solder bridge and connected the two pins that's not supposed to be. But if you look at it before you solder it, then you'll know that it's supposed to be that way. So I'll go ahead and get these two at the same time. Because if you don't notice it before you solder it, and then you go back to checking it, and you look at it and say, is that a solder bridge, or is that supposed to be that way? Sometimes you can tell it's that way, but there are times where the boards are made that you can't really tell. So the only way to find out for sure is to go ahead and suck the solder back off of it and check and make sure that the trace is made that way. Okay. Take a look and see what it looks like under the magnifying glass. Looks good. Okay, and there we have it. The video board, all the sockets on it, ready to be repopulated. The only other thing I'll probably do is I'll probably go back and check my work. And I may go ahead and take some alcohol and a flux brush, which is a stiff bristled brush, and clean all the sockets off where I just soldered, and that way if there's any little balls of solder that's left on the board stuck in the flux, it'll wash that away too. So just something that you need to do when you solder. You don't want to leave the flux behind anyway. So we'll do that, and probably end this video right here. I don't know what order yet I'm going to do this in, but I might go ahead and release the video with the, if I do, you already know, burning the ROMs. So, and then we'll come back and we'll install the ROMs. And once we repopulate the board, the only one thing to do is to hook it all back up and find out if we have any life in the board. So stick around. That'll be exciting, and hopefully it's going to work, but you never know, it might not. If it doesn't, then we just have to regroup and see what we can figure out. So until the next time, well, can't say this has been an arcade fix. Well, we have fixed it. We put sockets in, so it's just another arcade fix. Have you had your arcade fixed today?
I want a gazookas, which takes all the lookers, but takes honey up and square up. Why, fifth and I bottom, and always I've got them, but none of them get nowhere.